Hello student, very good morning to all of you. How are you? I hope you all are happy, healthy and fine at home. Do you remember what were we discussing yesterday? I think yesterday we were discuss about the scheme number 5, and that scheme number 5 is written over here: enantiomer selective synthesis of plus minus sabine-canadine E from S acetoxycinamide via an unanticipated syn addition of the cuprate. And how, starting from the compound number 26, added as a proper reagent and maintaining as a reaction condition, we got the structure number 27. That is a possible structure we have represented, we have saw over there. And after that 27, we converted that structure into as a 28, and on that 28 further reagent added, we got as a structure number 29, that is minus 29. When that 29 further treated with sodium hydride as a base, THF as a solvent, stirred at 25 degree centigrade for 10 minutes only, you will get, they have got is a 90% of the yield, and the product is a this one, that is a minus 30, which is represent over here. That is alpha beta unsaturated compound is got over there, and on that treated with the allyl magnesium chloride in presence of cuprous bromide, then that here we are getting that is the structure number minus 19. With this, these are the reagent condition and the reagent used over there, and we got as a, this is a structure number plus minus 19, where over 99% diastereomeric excess and enantiomeric excess, and which is confirmed by H1 NMR, that is a nuclear magnetic resonance, and HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography, by using that we have seen. And the remaining, and what we are going to discuss right now, the rest of the, now when we got as a structure number, here is a 9, after that we are going to get other reagent. Now let me show over here, after getting as a this, when this is treated with, here treated this structure number 9, minus 9, treated with, where is a 8 steps from scheme number 2, scheme number 2, and the overall yield obtained is a 82%, and the structure which we got over here is a this one. Let us see the structure which we got is a this one. And let me draw that structure properly over here. This is a indole meiotic, remains as it is. Then there will be a 6-membered ring further attached with, that is a here, then double bond, this group is there. Now here is a hydroxy group, then this is a again one of the hydroxy group at over there. This is nothing but as a plus minus 17 structure. This is the structure where we can solve only as a plus 17. That is the structure we got over here. And this structure, when 17 number structure, when further treated with the reagent, the reagents are like this over here. Now let me draw these structures once again properly over here, so that you can clearly observe that structure. So here I am writing the structure number 17 is this one. Here N H, that is a indole meiote remains as it is. Then there will be a 6-membered ring further attached with the this one. Here is a double bond methyl group. Here is a hydroxy group over here. Here also has a hydroxy group. HO is written over there. This is a structure number plus 17. Look at this one. And this structure further treated with the reagents. The number one reagent added over here is this one, TSCl, tosyl chloride, in presence of triethylamine and dimethyl ammonium phosphoroxide, then 0 degree centigrade to 25 degree centigrade, 25 degree centigrade, 6 hours, 6 hours. Second one, second reagent will be this one, lithium bromide, LiBr, lithium bromide, reflux, 3 hour, lithium bromide reflux, 3 hour. Third one, Zn, reflux 3 hour again, reflux 3 hour, and the percentage is obtained 59%. 59% overall yield is obtained. All the three steps in one spot. All the three steps in one pot. So this, observe the structure 17 carefully. These are the sum of the reagent properly added over there one by one, and all the three steps in one spot, and finally we will get our target molecule, which is this one. Let me draw that molecule over here. This is a indole meiote. Then there will be this one, N. This is attached over there, double bond methyl group, and where here is also a double bond, and this nitrogen, and this is added over here. This is shown like this, and there is a hydrogen atom, and this is a structure, is nothing but our target molecule. And as we know that target molecule means what, whose synthesis is being planned. After doing all these things, we have got our desired product, which is sabine canadine, canadine E. That is a structure which we are trying to synthesize. We got this structure, and which has an absolute configuration. One chiral center is there, and that one chiral center where there is a R configuration is obtained. If you trying to give the priority number according to as a, what we can call it as a, here, like as a, here we will get 1, 2, then 3, it looks as the R. But as I told you during the that yes, acetaloxysacinamide, where we found according to as a Fischer projection formula, what the Fischer projection formula tells us, that you apply that formula, and according to that you have to convert this chiral center, you imagine over there. Now among these two groups, one is a, which one has a most oxidizable, this one has a most oxidizable. If you see over here, so you can write over here like this, and this should be the fourth priority, means hydrogen atom, it should be below the plane. Now look at this, is you have to represent on a right hand side, and this you on left hand side, right hand side you can write this is a CH2 and further attached OD. So here this one get as a first priority, this one should be at the second priority, and this will be the third. And observe moment 1, 2, 2, 3 and fourth priority, which is at the bottom, and therefore it has a S configuration. S configuration. This is absolute configuration. By applying this rule, then and then you can able to find out the S. Otherwise, directly on the on that molecule, you will get confusion over there. So for assigning, so this will be the absolute configuration, means the heading total synthesis of plus minus sabine canadine and determination of absolute configuration. This is absolute configuration which we have just shown over here. So that is the absolute configuration we got in this case. So now the analytical and the spectral, the analytical and the spectral data obtained for seen product minus 9 were in complete agreement with the earlier obtained data for seen product plus minus 9 from scheme number 2, which is represented in the scheme number 2. Whatever spectral data we have obtained from the scheme number 2, which is totally agreement with the whatever we have obtained from scheme number 5. Such a type of seen addition precedence is known in the literature. However, genesis of stereo selection still remains an unanswered question. The seen product minus 9 was transformed to plus diol 17 in 62% overall yield by repeating 8 steps from scheme number 2. 1-pot 3-step transformation of plus diol 17 under Zhai and co-workers condition delivered the desired plus sabine canadine E 18 in 59% yield. The analytical and spectral data obtained for plus sabine canadine E 18 were in complete agreement with the reported data, including specific rotation, that is natural alpha D23+39.0 concentration 1.0 in methanol, synthetic structure number 18 alpha, means specific rotation was found to be D25+42.3, where the concentration is employed 0.12 methanol in methanol. Enantioselective first total synthesis of plus sabine canadine E18 was accomplished from S acetoxysacinamide 26 with 18% overall yield, and sinister means S configuration was assigned to the natural product. Conclusion. In summary, from the readily available malimide / succinamide, we describe a few efficient approach to plus minus / plus sabine canadine E and establish its absolute configuration. The 1,4 addition of Grignard's reagent to the internally activated lactamol witnessed position selective allylic rearrangements in succinamide derived lactamols, and stereoselective seen addition of cuprate to the unsaturated lactam are noteworthy. Our present synthetic strategy is flexible and paves efficient enantioselective routes to Sabine Canadin AG and focus mini library of their unnatural congeners and derivatives for structure activity studies. Now we are at the end of this total synthesis where the experimental section. In the experimental section, what are the point to raise or what are the point to mention? That is a point, the common points which are repeatedly you can observe in the experimental sections are general description. In the general description, melting points are uncorrected. Melting points are measured and found to be uncorrected, or sometimes it is written as a melting points are uncorrected, or melting points are recorded, or melting points are determined on so machine, and it was found to be uncorrected. And in the next point, the common point which is generally used in experimental sections are the H1 NMR, means proton nuclear magnetic resonance spectra, were recorded on 200, 400, 500, 600, 700, whichever the machine available in the market, sophisticated machine nowadays for recording of this HN1 NMR, which give the whole stereochemistry as well as environment around that proton, what kind of the environment it has, and from that the chemists are able to know the complete structure of the organic compound. And that's why in every experimental section that type of the points or the one sentence always there over here in that. That is, instruments are generally in a megahertz. NMR spectrometers using solvent residue signal as an internal standard. H1 NMR in CdCl3, deuterated chloroform, deuterated acetone, or deuterated methanol, DMSO, D6 250, carbon-13 NMR, similar to as a H1 NMR or carbon-30 NMR, and from carbon-30 NMR we are getting the complete information about the number of carbon atom, how many number of carbon atoms are present. By observing that spectrum, you can easily interpret what kind of the carbon atom, nature of that carbon atom, we are getting information about that one. So in that, CdCl3 generally at 77 ppm, CD3OD 49 ppm, DMSO D6 that is 3951. The carbon-13 NMR spectra were recorded on 200 NMR 50 MHz, 400 NMR 100 MHz, and 500 NMR that is 125 MHz spectrometers. HRMS means ESI were taken on an arbitrary quadrupole plus ion trap and TOF mass analyzer. Time of flight, the IR spectra were recorded on IR spectra. From IR spectra we are getting information about the functional group, how many functional groups are there and what kind of the functional groups are present in the compound. That are the complete information we are getting from IR. And therefore in the experimental section they are mentioning the IR spectra were recorded on FT IR spectrometer, column chromatography, separations were carried out on silica gel 6120 mesh and 23400 mesh. Commercially available starting materials and reagent were used. These are the general things you have to mention in the experimental section. And then actual, whatever the compounds, let us see, one is a malamide, that is a one allele, 11B, E, prop, EN, that is automatically if you put that structure, you will get the name of that compound. So that will be the IUPAC, because the complex molecule has a very complex names, and so you will get computerized. Nowadays there is advanced computer technology, softwares are there, and from that we can easily get that name of that compound. But that let us see, compound number 1 taken in 2 gram, 8.33 millimole, and in dry TH40 ml, that is a tetrahydrofuran as a solvent, was added solution of allyl magnesium chloride in THF 2 molar 16.6 ml milliliter 33.33 millimole oblique in a drop wise mode at minus 78 degree centigrade under argon atmosphere. The reaction mixture was stirred, that is the general procedure I am talking about. The reaction mixture was stirred for 1 hour at the same temperature and then allowed to reach 25 degrees, and it was further stirred, and the reaction was quenched with saturated aqueous ammonium chloride solution at 0 degree centigrade. The reaction quenched before the experimental there will be a conclusion. Before that, in a summary, from the readily available malanamide or succinamide, we describe a few efficient approach to plus minus sabine canadin E and establish its absolute configuration. And the 1,4 addition of Grignard's reagent to the internally activated lactamal witnessed position selective allelic rearrangement in succinamide derived lactamal and stereoselective sheen addition of cuprate to the unsaturated lactam are noteworthy. Our present synthetic strategy is flexible and paves an efficient enantioselective route to succinamide A2G and focus mini library of their unsaturated congeners and derivatives for structure activity relationship studies, that is actually studying over here. And finally, the reaction was quenched with saturated aqueous ammonium chloride solution at 0 degree centigrade. The reaction mixture was concentrated in Wasco and the obtained residue was dissolving ethyl acetate 80 ml. Then the organic layer was washed with water and brine and dried over Na2SO4, that is a chemical used for drying. The concentration of organic layer in Wasco offered lactamal 4, which was directly used for the next step to a stirred solution of lactamal 4 in THF approximately 25 ml was added to normal HCl 1.50 ml at 0 degree centigrade, and the reaction mixture was stirred for 6 hours and allowed to reach 25 degree centigrade. The reaction was quenched with saturated ammonium carbonate at 0 degree centigrade, and the aqueous layer was extracted with ethyl acetate 3 × 25 ml. The combined organic layer was washed with brine and dried over Na2SO4. Concentration of the organic layer in Wasco followed by purification of the obtained residue by column chromatography, silica gel 6120 mesh, ethyl acetate P 30H2-7 offered single diastereomer plus minus 9 as a yellow solid near about 1.40 gram and 55% melting point were 83 to 55. So in this way they have represented, and the spectral data are given by looking as a base structure where this one, this NH where it will found, this is a chiral center where it will then CH2, what type of the protons are there and the number of carbon atom, and by studying all this spectral data and they have confirmed the structure of plus acinamide. Why we are studying? Because it shows as a cytotoxic biological activity, and therefore I think in this way we have completed the section number 1, the course which we are learning MEC, second organic chemistry, semester 4, CC TP 10 CHO 450, chemistry of natural properties. Section 1 is over here completely, and if I get as a time, because still there is a section number 2 and we are in July, 15 July, so whenever when I complete the section 2, totally there is a 2 molecules are there in section 2. One is a vanucels A and B, and another one is a pinaic acid. These are the 2 molecule we are going to discuss in our next lecture, means in the section 2. So that time, after completing that 2 molecule, then I will, due to that COVID pandemic, all the examination are now multiple choice questions. So for MSc, after completion of the whole syllabus, I will try to make the lectures how to solve multiple choice question, or what type of the probable multiple choice question may appear in your exam and how you can solve it. What is the trick, what is the method of getting or for solving that multiple choice question. I think whenever we get as a time after the completion of that section number 2, I will definitely going to take the lecture on multiple choice question, section 1 as well as section 2. On section 1, suppose that is the molecule which we have learned is a longifolin. Then second one is a, what is that? Hirsutolun B. Then third molecule we have learned, that is ribosines A and B, and the fourth one, this one is a plus sabine canadine E, and on each molecule I will make in future the multiple choice question, and I hope it will benefit. But when you are able to, when you are capable of solving that multiple choice question, when you know all these molecules in detail, because if you study these molecules in detail, then and then whatever the paper setter, they can set any kind of the multiple choice question, because that for solution of that multiple choice question, while answering that multiple choice question, or to select the proper alternative from that fourth one, which one is the correct one. So that type, that kind of the trick, I will provide you in my future lecture after completion of this. So I will try to complete the next section as early as possible whenever I get as a time. Till then, I think with this brief introductory and the recap of the story of our section first, course number CCTP 10, that is a credit system, 2 credit here is over here. So and as we know that the pattern of examination, and we are discussing in our starting lecture also. So I think with this, let us stop today here. Thank you. Have a nice day.